Welcome to Saints and Feasts of the Catholic Calendar, meeting the greatest men and women who have ever lived. June 24th, birth of St. John the Baptist, 1st century, patron saint of converts and epileptics. A rugged forerunner cuts a path for his cousin. Dies Natalis means birthday or anniversary in Latin. But for early Christians, Dies Natalis referred to a martyr's date of death and its subsequent commemoration in the Church's liturgy, most typically through the assigning of a feast day. Most saints, martyrs or otherwise, are commemorated on or near the date of their death, the date their body was transferred to its final resting place, or on another significant date in their lives, date of ordination, coronation as pope, consecration as nun, etc. Besides Christ himself, only two saints' birthdays are commemorated liturgically. The Virgin Mary's on September 8th, exactly 9 months after the feast of her Immaculate Conception, and St. John the Baptist on June 24th, today's feast. St. Mary and St. John were both sanctified or made holy before they first opened their eyes to the light or ever gulped a mouthful of fresh air. A long span of years did not turn them into saints. God made them holy from the start. So we commemorate their lives from the start, from their birthdays. Only the Gospel of St. Luke tells us the details of John's birth. John's mother and father were Elizabeth and Zechariah. They were beyond the age for having children. But Zechariah, a priest who served in the temple in Jerusalem, was told one night by the archangel Gabriel that Elizabeth would give birth to a boy they must name John. Zechariah was dumbfounded. Literally, when he disbelieved this annunciation, he was rendered speechless until the child's birth. When his speech was finally restored, a torrent of praise gushed out in the canticle known as the Benedictus. It is prayed as part of the breviary every single day at morning prayer by hundreds of thousands of priests and nuns the world over. Zechariah's prayer of praise lives on. The celebration of the Nativity of John the Baptist is perhaps the oldest liturgical feast day in all Christendom, much older than the feast of Christmas itself. It was at one time celebrated with three distinct masses, vigil, dawn, and daytime, just like Christmas still is. The beheading of John, celebrated on August 29th, is of equally ancient origin. The oldest liturgical books, even incredibly, indicate that there was once a liturgical commemoration of the conception of John the Baptist, celebrated 9 months prior to his birth, on September 24th. Today's feast is placed 3 months after the Annunciation, on March 25th, because the Gospel scene tells us that Elizabeth, John's mother, was pregnant for 6 months at the time. Three more months take us to June 24th. Three related feast days then line up beautifully. March 25th, the Annunciation. June 24th, the birth of John the Baptist. December 25th, the birth of Christ. John's birth foretells Christ's birth. Although the historical chronology may not be exact, the dates show the theological interconnection among the three feasts. All parents are naturally curious to discover the sex of their child in utero. Some allow themselves to be told the sex, others wait in high suspense. Elizabeth and her spouse Zechariah were told by a winged messenger of God himself that they would have a boy. That little boy grew to be a man, a great man among men who accepted death rather than swallow his words criticizing the powerful Herod Antipas. John ran ahead of Christ, clearing the ground so that the Lord's pathway would be clear. This forerunner baptized the Christ, preached and prophesied like the Christ, fasted and prayed like the Christ, and died for the truth like the Christ. But he did not rise from the dead like the Christ. There is only one Easter. We rejoice at St. John the Baptist's birth because what followed merits rejoicing. We rejoice at his birth because of the generous God who intervenes in our lives, who discovers us before we discover him. May the birth of St. John the Baptist deepen our love for all unborn babies who must be given the chance to grow, to live, and to become the great men and women God invites them to be. God respected the laws of human biology when intervening in history. May we follow his example of seeing every child, every life as a gift. Amen.